Hey, you're checking out O&A, Opie and Anthony, 877-692-1027. The blind guys are here, Anthony.
Yes.
I think you're having second doubts, aren't you?
No, I was, you know, they're nice guys, and the one guy, who is it? It's Blind Dave.
And Blind Matt.
And Blind Matt. Blind Matt's got a dog.
Blind Matt has a dog.
He's got the CNI dog.
We've already told him he can't use the dog in the boxing
That'd
match.
Be great. All of a sudden he goes for the legs and just...
But we're going to have to hide the dog because if Dave starts, you know, punching Matt...
I know.
The dog may get pissed off and want to jump in. We got problems here today. What the hell are we going to do? We got to say hi to Bill Dwyer real fast. Hey, Bill.
Hey.
It's Opie and Anthony. We got you live. What's going on, man?
You guys are the greatest. Listen, you got to put the dog somewhere else because he's going to go ape.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Are there no rules anymore to blind boxing? Are there no more sanctions to blind boxing?
Of course, we're talking to one of the announcers of BattleBots.
Yes.
We have our own little thing that we like to call Crippled Bouts, Bill.
I know. I heard about it. Oh man, I can't wait to check out the one-legged boxers.
One-legged boxing happened yesterday. The clip we have on our website is hilarious. Hilarious. The one guy just got killed. Got killed. Bill.
We had a three-legged dog when I was a kid, and we'd make him sit, and then we'd try and make him give us his paw.
That is cruel. That is cruel.
I'm cruel. And you guys are introducing the contestants as Blind Matt and Blind Dave.
Well, they're blind, and that's their name.
Well, yeah.
They're really blind, and they both have great senses of humor, man.
Hey, Bill, it's not like we're letting poor defenseless machines go in the middle of an arena to bash each other, so don't be a hypocrite.
Hey, we're copying BattleBots. We have, like, obstacles in the ring and everything for the blind guys.
What do I care?
We have a hacksaw that just pops up in the middle of our boxing ring. Man, are the blind guys going to be surprised when that happens?
That's why you got to lay the titanium over your sack.
Yeah. One of the things we got going is very reminiscent of BattleBots. We're going to get two guys, each in wheelchairs, and we're going to give them various weapons they could choose from, like the mace or the lance or a big hammer, and we're going to let them go at it in our arena. And it'll look like BattleBots, I think.
Yeah, it's called wheelchair jousting.
Yeah.
Why are you guys in radio? Why not pay-per-view?
Oh, I know.
Pay-per-view. That's what I say.
Pay-per-view's on the way, my friend.
I miss you guys, by the way.
Well, yeah, when are you going to be in New York?
I don't know. Soon?
Get back here. We had fun last time you were in.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had a ball.
This is the day you should be here. Blind boxing, come on.
Yeah. Tell me about it. Are they going to wear, like, special beeping things on their heads?
They got little bells.
Cat bells.
Really?
Cat bells.
Cat bells.
Yeah.
So when they jingle, they'll know where to go.
Hey, 16-ounce gloves?
They're pretty heavy gloves,
yeah.
Sure. Yeah, it's
16-ounce gloves? Okay, it'll get to hurt too badly.
It's real boxing equipment.
I'm truly excited.
Hey, should we bring the blind guys in while we have Bill on the line?
Sure. Maybe he wants to ask a question.
I'll make sure I don't say, have you guys ever seen BattleBots? You know, I'll try not to make that awkward moment.
Well, the one guy said to the other day, he goes, I'm going to run circles around you. And the other guy goes, we'll see.
We'll see. No. You won't.
No. You'll feel the wind.
Yeah. But the one-legged boxing yesterday, classic, because the one guy was in really good shape. I wouldn't mess with him.
Yeah.
I'm not even kidding. Yeah. He works out all the time, and when he was hopping on his one leg, it was very, very nice and very controlled, up and down, short strokes, right?
Yeah.
The other guy, when he was hopping, he would hop like 3 feet to the right, 4 feet back to the left.
Side to side. He's going in with two hands trying to punch. It was really bad.
How long did he last?
Seconds.
Oh, man.
And then just got knocked right the F out.
All right, we're sitting Blind Dave and Blind Matt, right?
There they go. Look at the dog.
Hey, Blind Dave, what's up?
What's up, man?
Hey, someone's got to put the mic in front of his face. He doesn't know. All right, you got
there
it.
There you go.
All right, I got it.
All right, we have Bill Dwyer from BattleBots on the line.
Hey, Matt and Dave.
Have you guys ever... never mind.
You ever listen to BattleBots?
No, but I heard him on your show. He's real funny.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
There's no reason to listen to BattleBots, I would assume.
Why?
Well, maybe there. I don't know.
Sure there is. Oh, Opie.
Yeah? Are you going to make fun of me?
Remember...
He's going to make fun of me. Here we go.
No. The guy has a dog with him, and I believe him, but remember my test?
What's your
crinkle,
test?
Crinkle, crinkle. When I was here last time.
Crinkle, crinkle. Oh, right. Throwing the paper.
Ah!
Throwing...
I want equal testing.
Oh, you want to make sure. I know what he's saying.
If you throw something at me, Precious, it'll be you and me with the gloves on.
I think we could assume he's blind. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think, you know, who's going to go the distance and get the dog and everything?
What Dave is saying, Bill.
Dogs are cheap.
What Dave is saying, last time we had Dave in here, we didn't really believe that he was blind, so we threw a piece of paper to see if he would react to it. And he wants us to do that to Matt because he wants to make sure he's fighting a true blind guy.
Oh.
But he, yeah. I'd say he's blind. Yeah, can you see anything, Matt?
No, I can't. I have two prosthetic eyes.
It's completely...
Those are fake eyes?
They are.
Wow.
No.
Can you take them?
Bless
take
the
him
artist.
Out?
I could.
Well, let's not. No, I cannot deal with that.
Do it.
Opie, I'm not looking.
Do it. Wait, I'm sure a bunch of people have told you. Those are really good eyes.
Yeah, they're not bad. It's and if I wasn't listening through headphones, I'd probably look right at you when we were talking, but
really?
It's deceiving. It sounds like you're in my head.
And you oh, Jesus. And you could
cuz the blind guys have the super ears.
Hey, there's no chance an eye is going to pop out if Dave punches you.
No, I certainly hope not. I mean, I can.
Oh, my God. Wait, can you pop one of the eyes out?
No, Opie. Yeah,
is it hard to do?
Oh! Wait,
holy ass. Holy ass!
Oh,
my God, no. No, he just did it.
Oh, that is great. Where's the live camera?
Oh, my God.
Holy ass!
Opie, you suck, man.
Why? No, I wanted it too, man. I want to know.
How easy was
Let
that?
Let me tell you something, Dave. I can tell you for sure that this guy is blind.
Too. Okay. Well, that's one eye, though. I don't know if the other one might see good.
Oh, my God. I've never seen anything like that before.
What are you
No, know what sucks is
that rocks. That's a good party trick, man.
Oh, it used to be a great party trick.
You're invited really to my balls. Next party because look at him. The eyes look completely like he has normal eyes. When he stares in your direction, looks like he's got, you know, he's looking at you and he can pop it out.
Hey, invite me to the next Opie party. I'll be there with eyes out.
The road show?
I'm feeling beaten here.
Let me tell you something. If we bring him to the next road show in front of 3,800 people, he does that trick.
Oh,
you think
God.
You think we got a reaction when Big Butt Mendy shows her butt? Matt, that's... Wow. What do you guys
Does
think?
Does he pop out both eyes?
You ever sneeze and have him just fly
just
out?
Just one, but the other one works as well. Comes out also.
Sweet.
I was talking to a friend the other day, and they were like, what color eyes would you want if you could have them? I said, any color I want. All I got to do is go to the artist and tell him what color I want.
Yeah, you could put in some wacky vampire eyes,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, skull and crossbones.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hey, when you're hungover, do you pop in the bloodshot ones?
That's
all. You know? realism, right?
Matt, you got to watch out. Gay Marco might get horny here in this.
Matt, how long have you been blind?
Since I'm 5. I'm 31. Five.
Wow.
No, oh, Game man. Marco, I will not leave an eye out for you.
It's probably the only that place he hasn't violated on some guy. Jesus.
Oh, blind Steve, even though I talked to you on the phone and you sound like a nice guy, you're still a puss because you're not here, even though it's your friend.
Oh, Steve, they're talking to you, baby.
Yeah, blind. You still talked a lot of crap, but it's 2 days later. You couldn't make it 2 days ago and you couldn't make it today. You're a pod.
Wow. Yeah, Blind Dave really wanted to fight Blind Steve, but he's got Blind Matt. His
it
eyes
sucks,
pop out.
I'm not mad at this guy.
Hey, guys, since I'm not there, how does this match look between the two blind guys? Do they look pretty evenly matched?
Yeah, they're about the same height,
yeah.
I would say.
I'd say this is pretty even.
Hey, Dave, okay. How tall are you?
About 6'1".
And Matt?
5'9 and a half. So
he's got the height advantage.
He's got the weight, too. I'm about 170.
You guys discussed all this on the line?
No, but I heard Stephen was telling me the other day that Dave is 6'1 and about 200 or something.
Yeah.
And how was the limo ride?
Oh, gotta thank Caro.
Caro from Vital Transportation or whatever.
No, Top Notch Limo there. I know Opie's beeping it out.
You know what?
No, but
they sent their
really
best
cool.
limo for you guys.
It was a van. It wasn't a limo.
You could tell. Even the blind guy could tell that.
No, but it was really...
This is something we make fun of all the time in the show. Even the blind guy knew that he was in a bus and not a limo.
It was really cool. It was really like a luxury ride. The guy was really cool to us. And I tried to slip the guy a few bucks even, and he would not take it. And he let us smoke. And no one lets you do that. And he was there at like 12:45. And I get a thing from Rick saying, instead of 2:00, it might be more around 1:30. It's like 12:45. There's a car outside. Someone, beeping.
I got to ask Steve. Steve, did you get video of Blind Matt?
Yeah, I did. I caught the tail end of it. If you wouldn't mind, can you pop the other one out?
We would put it on the website. You would be the star.
Wait.
Okay.
Not yet.
Hold on. This is the other eye, Dave, to prove that this guy's completely blind.
Yeah, because I know I
send it to the satellite right now, gentlemen.
I'm not looking.
I need to see this.
For all I know, I could be getting set up. They could just be, Opie could be hamming it up.
No,
people know when I'm, people want to, people
know. I'm guessing with a dog.
See, he's banging the eyeball on the mic for you.
Oh, God, don't bang it up.
Who was talking in this mic last?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God, that is unbelievable.
I will wear, that blindfold, and Anthony, take a look through it. And see if you can see anything.
Oh, no, this gets completely blacked out.
Well, I have a little bit of sight, but just
Matt,
to make it even, I will
wear Matt, you know about that. Dave, can you see our faces right now?
Vision. No, not at all.
What do you see right now?
Shadows. He's lights and shadows. How about
Everything looks black to here. I see a light over here. If I look this way, I see that there's a light right somewhere.
Oh,
there.
So you're just seeing, like, little spots of light.
And
so
I
what's
see.
The game plan? To put me with a lit-up lamp or something on my head?
With a light on your head. That's it? You just see little pieces of light?
No, I see light in dark, but like my right eye saw little fragments of stuff, but that's kind of gone. But my left eye, I could see Anthony's hand.
Oh, really? On the mic?
No, right
here. Oh, on the table?
On your leg?
Yeah. He could be spanking it for all I know.
I'm not. Wow.
I just need to ask the listener something. If we put a still shot of blind Matt popping his eye out,
yeah,
would you check it out on WNEW.com?
I think they'd check it out.
That's when my eyes go. That's what I want, man. When my eyes are completely gone, I want them out of my head so I can do that.
It definitely gets
that's
places.
That's a talent, man.
I got to ask a really stupid question, Dave. Is there any hope for you? I mean, because I'm sure you're up on the research.
There is hope, and there is actually a number that I don't have with me for. I mean, RP is a horrible, slow torture disease where you lose your sight little by little, and I didn't bring the number because, to be frank, to be truthful, if I didn't have it, I wouldn't give a rat's ass.
Oh, you know, wow, that's honest.
It's like, do you think Christopher Reeves gave a rat's ass about quadriplegics before he became one?
No.
No.
So for me to sit here and go, give to the blind people, I'm trying to help them, it would be a bunch of BS. I would be wanting to help me.
Oh, man.
Because I wouldn't really care if it hadn't happened to me. But I do know now what it's like, you know, to be on the other side.
Yeah, right. You know what, though, Dave? Yeah, you're doing something cool for the show. You got to give us a number.
I
know, tomorrow or Monday or something. Because there are people out there that'll, you know.
Yeah, because there are hundreds of people that call people the phone every night, and it would do better for it to go on your show. And that's not a plug for someone trying to get over or someone trying to get their business going or something like that.
How close are they to figuring something out, though?
It'll probably be like, we could have fixed you if it was 10 years ago.
Oh.
You know how that is, but... You know, I'm sure sometime in my lifetime it'll be fixable, but it'll probably be where it's too late for me. I don't know.
And in
that
my
sucks.
Case, they say that there is hope that someday there will be a chance that, obviously I don't have the machinery, as y'all just saw, but that they could hook some sort of camera device up to my brain or something like that. But I've been blind since I'm 5, and I'm just happy this way.
Yeah,
I don't want to have to look at the sorry bastards I call my friends. So I'm just dandy.
Hey, Bill, are you in shock yet?
I can't believe it. I'm on the website too, hoping you guys will pop something on there.
We just sent the pictures. They're going to be up on WNEW.com.
Oh, and here
there's a picture that Steve was brave enough to take because Rick pushed out. And what, you took a picture of Matt with the eye out of his...
Yeah, I got one real close-up shot of Matt's left eye socket.
Yes.
And then one of him holding the glass eye up and smiling.
Proudly.
Yes, very proudly.
Matt, you rock.
And let me tell you, the guys who made these eyes, little plug for LeGrand Associates, are they hell of artists or what?
Yeah, definitely.
Hand-painted, baby.
Dave, you have a driver's license?
My friend who I don't know if he's out here or not, but in here or not, but
he's outside.
I was legally blind, right? And it was almost 4 years ago this October, it was like in November or whatever. I didn't have the cane yet, and I could see good enough where I could pass myself off. And my friend goes, and in Connecticut, you don't have to take an eye test. You just renew your license. So my friend goes, okay, it's like 10 paces, and then feel the blue carpet, and there's a chair about 3 steps to the right. Sit down in it. Don't mess up. And oh, no. And then I went, and I got my picture taken, and I was legally blind. I don't drive, so I'm not out to kill nobody. But
that's hilarious.
And then I went up. They called my name. He was renewing his license, and it was an invisible ink pen. And he goes, "Oh no, he's not going to know." And I just went up and I felt my pockets, and I go, "Damn it, I forgot my reading glasses. Can you put my finger where I got a sign?" And we walked out of there, and he's laughing his ass off. And I'm like, "What?" And he goes, "You're blind, and they just renewed your license." and that's bad.
You know what? He's not kidding. I'm holding his license in front of me,
and it's valid. And I had a CDL for driving large trucks.
Nice.
I was a tree worker. I drove chip trucks and bucket trucks. You know, that was my thing, man.
You take unbelievable.
Did he have a thing on the license that says corrective lenses needed?
Yeah, it did. And that's why the guy didn't bitch about the reading glasses. I said, you see it says right there, He's like, "Yeah, here, move your finger this way," and did it. And I was like, "I can't believe this guy's doing this." So if I get away with it this October, that would be...
Yeah, now if you do it again...
I think you guys should camera and mic me for it.
Yeah.
Hey, we'll...
Because I'll try.
We'll broadcast the whole thing.
We'll do that.
We'll take bets and everything. Let's see if Dave could renew his license again.
Yeah, it's October.
So you guys have no problem with the blind boxing?
No, we're going to give it a shot.
Give it a shot and stuff. We got bells.
That helps.
All right. What about the dog, Matt?
I'll leave him somewhere where he can't see.
Yeah, I don't want to be getting bit, man.
Because if the dog sees Dave attacking you, he's going
to... He may not be thrilled.
He's not going to be too happy.
Blind, so we'll leave him where purple. I won't be, and
yeah,
I'll
we'll put him somewhere.
You guys to lead me not into walls into the boxing circle.
No, we'll do whatever it takes.
Sure.
I mean, you guys are really cool.
This is part of the cripple thing, but I think you should call it the BBA on O&A, Blind Boxing Alcoholic. Opie and Anthony.
Yeah, you've been down in a couple of things of Jack.
I've been up.
As you can, for you guys, this is radio. I'm sweating
urinate.
And my back teeth are floating.
And we had to
urinate.
Yeah, we had to dump out of you. That's okay.
I have to urinate. I'm sweating. And
yeah. All right. Why don't we get Matt to the bathroom?
Okay, yeah, excuse me, gentlemen.
Now, don't worry. Everyone's treating you guys,
Make sure you don't trip over
totally
the cord
here.
I do that.
Hey,
that's
Bill.
A great
yeah, it's right
if
here.
If you go in the other room, Opie will be like, "Did you see that blind idiot?"
No, I won't. You know the show.
I want Opie in my corner, though, because Opie is the devious one.
No, I think Matt's cool. I have nothing bad to say to him, man.
No, this is good, but if Steve was here, that would be a better fight.
Yeah.
I would really want to hurt him.
You could still take on Steve.
We're going to videotape all this.
Hey, Bill.
And get it on
I am right here.
So what do you think?
I'm so excited.
Yeah.
I can't. I just wish I was there.
I know.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Well, you got to drop by.
Well, we're going to have video on foundrymusic.com. Mm-hmm. We're going to have a couple still shots on WNEW.com very, very soon. So, hey, Bill.
Yeah, that's where I'm at right now.
All right. Bill.
Yeah.
When's the new season start?
New season started Tuesday.
Tuesday.
They're going to be rerunning it, of course, because it's Comedy Central, rerunning it over and over. Friday, 9 p.m.
Cool. Check it out.
Oh, and it's sweet, man.
Yeah.
It's sweet.
You know what
it's
I heard?
It's no blind boxing.
You know what I heard, Bill? Like, the people that are getting involved now, it was at the beginning, you could put one together, maybe a couple $100, your spare time. Now these things are like thousands of dollars worth of machinery getting pounded.
Yeah, some guys are spending like, $20,000 on a
grand.
Robot.
20 grand. And how much do you win as first prize?
$8,000.
You watch your $20,000 machine get pummeled and you might get 8 grand. That's great.
A lot more sponsors, though, so.
Yeah, I know. Now they have the sponsors on some of the battle bots.
Guys getting sponsored, yeah. I mean, it's getting pretty heavy duty.
Any favorites returning?
All the champs returning, except for our middleweight champ from last season.
Yeah.
And, they're looking good. But, man, there are some awesome new bots.
Hold on. I just got really distracted because Dave needs a cigarette, and I said, no problem. Dave, what happened?
I felt my hair move.
You thought you lit your hair?
Oh, you were trying to light it? Well, you might not have a problem lighting it because you could see the light, right?
Nah, he
really can't.
You get calluses on your fingers. That's the biggest bitch if you're a smoker and you can't see that you're lighter. You start feeling, you know.
Right. So you feel for the flame to be there.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
So if somebody slips you like an extra long one, it screws you up because you're light in the middle of a cigarette.
I've seen BattleBots, man. It's a great show. You can take it from me. I definitely endorse it.
As did I, dude. And I don't know who does your color commentary, but they're pretty good from a blind perspective.
Oh, that's
look at
me.
That. That's Bill
us
Dwyer. Blind folks.
That's Bill.
That's me doing the color
that's
commentary.
You?
Yeah.
Oh, you're the man. Remember that there's at least two blind guys listening. So
that's
the best
cool.
detail you can give is there.
I got to remember that.
Remember that, dude. Walt Clyde Frazier used to do the color commentary for the Knicks on the radio.
Yeah.
You got to do some more bopping and dropping and slipping and whatnot.
That drives me nuts when Frazier starts using words I don't know.
I love that guy.
Yeah, well, Bob
but it's very auspicious.
Murphy commentating.
All right. Hey, Bill, we're going to let you go for now.
All right, you guys. I'll be on the website looking at it.
And next time you're in New York, you know, come on
by.
Yeah,
I'll be there.
Right on.
Cool.
Hey,
Bill. See you, boys.
It's Bill Dwyer. Check out BattleBots Friday on Comedy Central.
Yeah. If any ladies He's want to date dude. Me after looking at my eye socket after the website, give me a call at blah 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 blah.
Anthony does
kidding.
Does Mike Tyson, will he be calling in with any advice?
No, not at all. We don't know how to handle this one, Dave.
Punch him in the testicles.
There's no females involved?
Mark.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey, I used to go to school with Matt up in University of Hartford. This kid used to get laid left and right, didn't you, Matt?
Hey, baby, that's right.
Really? There you go.
We were freshmen. He used to have a keg in his closet.
I know. I
so
think I know who this
what?
Is.
This is Mark. I lived in Park Slope.
Was
right.
he good or what?
I know who this is, dude.
Greg, it's good to hear from you, buddy. I hope you kick this guy's ass.
We'll see what happens. But, hey, good to hear from you, too, man. We used to party in my dorm room. This guy nearly got me expelled.
Nah, just kidding. Was the blind angle pretty good with the chicks, though?
Well, I had a dog that was almost as good-looking as this, and that's all you need.
Yeah, the good-looking C&I dog.
You just need a cute dog.
Yep.
And then the girls come up, oh, hi, what's your dog's name?
Oh, exactly. And they all miss their dog because they're away at college and they're freshmen.
Oh, there you go.
Can I come to your room and pet your dog?
Yeah, and then I'll introduce you to the hog.
That's it. Here, pet this. That's my dog.
Guy, what's up?
What's going on, man? I was just going to say, you guys should keep this guy, Dave, on your show more often, man. He's a pretty funny guy.
Dave's really funny. We like him.
He's got a good radio voice.
We've had Dave on from time to time.
Really? Yeah. I never heard him before, but I was listening to you guys like 2 days ago, and sounded pretty funny, just him on the phone, but he's good.
Thanks, dude. I thought maybe it was...
Yo, check out...
What a douche. Jackass. All right. Well, I think we're going to take a break.
Yeah, we'll take a break, and we'll get everybody in position, and when we come back, we'll do some... blind boxing.
I just need to ask.
Big fag bandana.
The little Irish there.
Forgot my big fag cowboy hat.
Blind Dave doing some Irish.
Nice.
Not too bad, man. I just need to ask. Are the pictures up on WNEW.com of Matt? Ben is checking. Let's hold on a second. Very crucial.
Can we get Dave to show his brown eye?
Okay.
Okay.
If you want to see what we just saw, go to W.
Oh, they got a close up.
NEW.com.
Wow. I think it's more your brown eye, your red eye, actually.
Yeah, exactly.
We share with the listeners, and there you have it. 10 minutes after we saw it, you could see it.
Hey, remember, I asked for that. I'm the one who initiated it.
Wow.
When I go completely blind, that's what I want.
Okay.
Cool.
Anthony?
Yeah.
We got the clip of Blind Dave when he was last on our show live.
Oh, yeah.
And that was for the egg shooting with the lovely Ivory.
We had the girl shooting eggs. And let's just say, you know where.
Right.
Not even get into any detail, you know where. But she was able to fire these eggs.
Right.
Like up to 9 feet. We had Dave catching them in a basket.
That was after we had batting practice.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun. Here's the clip.
You're ripping me off. I had a blind guy on my show.
So we'll Close. Be back with Blind Dave and Blind Matt. It's blind boxing, minutes away on the Opie and Anthony show, right, Anthony? Hold on, here we go.
What? I told you.
No, I know. I was trying to, like, do it on the fly.
You couldn't do it?
I tried.
Did the beginning of this. Huh? Now, the beginning of this has something that can't be said on the air.
I believe they dumped out, and now it's okay. Here it is. Blind Dave, the last time he was live on our show.
Fooding Day.
Dave, the blind guy, is here. He's going to attempt to catch some of the eggs that are being shot out.
Yeah, look, she's already loaded up. She's got one in the clip.
Reloading. All right, she's loading you-know-what. She's leaning back.
Whoa!
Oh, wait a minute!
6 feet!
Hold on a minute!
Well, that's 8 feet.
All right, Ivory has reloaded.
Oh, that one. Yeah, that one just over 8 feet. About 8 feet, 2 inches, I would say.
We got the blind guy about 6 feet away from ground zero. Okay, here we go. Dave, the blind guy.
Oh, yeah! He got it! He got it! Oh, what a day for sport. Good eyes. Oh, sorry.
All right, we're back. Sorry. I was talking to Blind Dave and Blind Matt.
Yeah.
For the first time in my radio career, and I'm having second doubts about the bit we're about to do.
Are you doubting yourself?
A little bit. New Jersey cure, Ant.
Yeah, listen up. New Jersey drivers. A lot of insurance companies have low premiums. You have your first accident and they nail you. New Jersey Cure Auto Insurance cures what ails your insurance problems. What the hell am I saying? New Jersey Cure is a direct writer. It's like Geico, but only for New Jersey drivers. They eliminate the high cost of commissions for agents and middlemen. They've been insuring thousands of responsible Jersey drivers for over a decade, keeping their claims as low as possible. New Jersey Cure forgives drivers their 2 moving violation points. So if you have 4 points, they rate you like you only had 2. Also, NJ Cure is the auto insurer that's committed to and staying with New Jersey drivers. Take 5 minutes tonight. Fill out a quote request online. www.njcure.com. You get a detailed quote emailed right back to you. Remember, njcure.com or call them 1-800-535-CURE.
This is the Opie and Anthony Show. Toll free, 877-692-1027. If you're just tuning in, hello.
Oh, boy.
We're a few minutes away from blind boxing.
Yes.
Blind Dave is here, Blind Matt. Both of them great guys, funny guys. This is so effing wrong. You know, we've been doing a lot of articles lately, Anthony, for magazines.
Yeah.
We're going to be in Time Magazine, I think, next week.
Yep.
We're going to be in Rolling Stone Magazine in a few weeks, or maybe a month. We're going to be in New York Magazine. We did an article for FHM Magazine. I don't know what happened to that.
Yeah.
We're going to be in Playboy.
Yep.
We're going to be on 2020 Downtown. Mm-hmm. Fox News is doing a national story that airs next week. Right. Yes, Rick?
Yeah, it airs next week.
And every single interviewer has asked if we've ever done a bit where we wish we didn't do that bit.
Or feel that it crosses the line, they always call the line.
Thank God we did all our interviews because I think I finally have an answer to that question.
Yeah,
I'm just not feeling this one
today.
You're
not feeling very good about this? Yeah, I mean, they're two really nice guys, and they happen to be blind, and now we're putting them in a situation where they're going to be punching each other.
Oh, my
there's
God.
A dog running around. It's Steve. What are you feeling?
I just gotta say,
hold on, that mic's off because we're setting up the boxing ring.
Which one's on?
I don't try that one.
Yes.
Yeah, no? That's on. That's
yes.
On.
Okay. I just got to say, I walked by those two, and Matt was talking to Dave, and he said, "Look, man, just don't break my nose." And Dave says, "Dude, I don't know where your nose is. Don't worry about it." The trash talk starts.
Dude, I don't know where your nose is. I think we need to take some phone calls or something.
Oh, my God.
We're going to need judges. Who wants to be a judge for this?
What, just in case it comes down to points?
It's going to come down to points.
You think so?
Yeah.
How are we working? What's the format here? It's going to be rounds?
Yeah, three-minute rounds, I guess.
All right.
Is that good? I don't think we should do more than that.
2 minutes between rounds?
Something like that. Maybe we should get the guys back in. I want them to agree to everything. And then you and I will be a judge. Ben, you want to be a judge for this? Sure. Ben will be a judge. It'll be... That's all we need is three judges.
I thought someone blasted a fart again in here.
Wow, look what they're doing now, Anthony.
What? Drinking.
They're just getting comfortable.
Yeah.
Come on, guys.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Now Dave's telling us to wait.
Yeah, he's running the show.
All right, Matt's back in.
There he is.
I'm out of my working clothes and ready to kick some ass.
Oh, yeah. Got his Florida State shirt
got
on.
Got my Charles, whatever his loser name is. Charlie Ward.
Oh. Yeah, Florida State.
Yeah.
Where am I here?
You're right here. Hold on. Let me get the mic situated.
Dave, man.
We're not on
Dave's just chugging
yeah,
JD.
Wow.
Dave, man.
Woof.
Dave, relax on the JD, man.
Holy crap.
You know what? Maybe you're right.
Maybe you're right.
Dave, have another shot.
No, you have another shot. Come on, man. You got to be as drunk as me.
I was saying, dude, this guy has drank a lot of Jack on the way here, and he's not even slurring. Even when he does Imus, he's not
I'm
slurring.
I'm off the wagon.
You're off the wagon. You don't fall down just by being drunk.
Yeah.
Hell no, dude.
You do that now?
No.
No.
Good.
I'll take whatever help I can get.
Those are my muscles. My whiskey muscles.
Whiskey muscles he's pulling out.
Let's go to Cliff. Cliff, what's up?
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good.
I just wanted to say hi and good luck to my buddy Dave. I went to school with him, and my brother there with him. I just want to say hi and good luck to him.
Cliff,
what's up, man?
Yeah, how you doing, Dave? I hear you on the radio. You told me you were going to be on. I can't believe it.
Hey, Cliff, Kev was telling us a funny story the other day about you knocking on his door in the middle of the night. What was that about?
I don't know what the story was.
Your brother banging the 18-year-old hot chick.
Dave said it, not me.
Yeah, that's one time I would want to trade places with my brother.
Come on, was she really that hot or what?
Yes, she was.
All right. Other than that, you're not helping me too much, Cliff. Come on.
Dave, take it easy, man. I just want to wish you good luck and get my brother home safe, man.
All right.
I'll drive safe, man.
Okay, keep your eyes on the road. Hey, Dave.
Yeah.
Tell that guy to keep his eyes in his socket so you don't get your gloves stuck in there, man. He has an advantage if he takes his eyes out.
Yeah, you can see Matt.
Oh, that's an idea, man. Cliff. It's an idea.
There's a picture of Matt with his eye popped out on WNEW.com.
Yeah, check it out.
The website is just getting pounded.
Cliff, that's
anybody
as bad
with
as...
a weak stomach, check it out.
It's an interesting picture.
I need the headphones to know if Opie's going to throw anything at me.
No, I'm not going to throw anything.
We won't throw anything at you.
I'm pretty twisted. I'm pretty sick. I trust me. I'm not doing anything today.
Yeah. Well,
nothing.
I got on the Amtrak.
I am really creeped out about today's event.
This bit runs itself.
Yes.
I got something I think is funny.
All right.
I got on the Amtrak coming back from Boston, right?
Yeah.
And it's very dark in there, and so I'm completely blind. So I feel the backrest of seats to see if there's an open seat as I'm going down the aisle because I'm too ignorant to ask for help. And I touch, and there's no one in this seat. And there's people behind me, and I say, is anyone sitting there? And these guys go, no. And this woman apparently had Tourette's. And I've heard about it, and I've heard it on TV and this and that. But so I go... So I stick my cane in, and my cane hits her, and she goes, ah, bah, 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 bah. And I jump back into the people behind me and go, ah! And they're like, and she's going, bah, 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 bah. And I'm like, and she's trying not to say the F word, but it comes out, and she starts screaming it. And I'm just like, oh, my God. And she goes, and then she goes, I have Tourette's. And I knew,
hey,
I always thought it was a gag, but I knew. Yeah. I sat two seats ahead of her, and the train broke down twice. Thank you, Amtrak. And I knew any time that there was an African-American gentleman coming by us. Because
no way.
I thought it was a gag, but for God's sakes, every time someone African-American descent came by, she started going...
No way!
I swear to God,
knitting,
and I'm two seats ahead of her, and people are like, oh, that's horrible, and I'm like, and I'm I'm like laughing uncontrollably, trying to hold my mouth laughing, you know, and I told one of my friends, I was like, I really saw one of those Tourette's people, you know, I was like, well, I didn't see him, I heard her, and he's like, then he goes, man, that's bad, you shouldn't be laughing at that, look at what's happening to you, you shouldn't be laughing at other people, and I said, well, you know, my theory, hey, if you can't laugh at yourself, make fun of other people, you know. But it was funny, and there was a couple of African American gentlemen who were very peeved.
I guess
she was yelling throughout the car the N word, going Nick, 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 and then it would just come out to full blown.
Better just wear like one of those ball in the mouth things wherever you go to keep you out of trouble if you got that problem. Working for you.
Wow.
Oof.
And the most common question asked by people who used to see, who go blind by their friends is, how do you know when you're done wiping your ass?
You know, there's a guy in the line, and I didn't even want to go there. What's the answer, though?
I didn't want to go there. But how do you know?
You just keep wiping.
Right.
Till it feels good.
See, blind people probably got the cleanest butts around. They just keep going.
Right.
I thought maybe you just smelt it.
That's a trick, too.
Use your sense of smell. No, it's still a little something there.
Charlie.
Yeah, O&A.
What's up?
I want to know if you guys are going to do this a la Hear No Evil, See No Evil, where each one of you guys get on their shoulders and tell them what time to hit them at. 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock.
No, it's they're going to have bells.
As Stephen Wright said, we wait till 12 or 1 o'clock, we'll be here all night.
Right. Uh-huh. Kenny.
Yo.
Hey.
What's up, buddies?
What's up?
You guys shot a bottle rocket out of a girl's intimate part, and you're worried about two guys hitting each other.
Oh, I thought you were going to say I should shoot a bottle rocket out of my eye socket. Not happening.
No. Let's start the bell, guys. Let's go.
All right, Kenny, thank you.
Are you on the Prozac or the Zoloft?
Yeah, how are you going to do in the fighting? I hear you almost taking the Zoloft.
Yeah. Yeah, I was on, they gave me a Paxil.
They gave you Paxil instead?
It was like, went insane.
Does that help blindness? Give me some.
See, for this...
No, I went like insane.
Holy smokes.
Did you?
I went back to the doctor and I had a bag full of these boxes and I threw them at him. He goes, how'd that work out? I was like, well, I wound up at a hospital in Lowell, Massachusetts. I thought I was going to die. You know, and he's like... Oh, so those weren't working out. I went to see the guy this morning. A month and a half ago, I went on the wagon, which I'm obviously off. Dr. Robin, if you're listening, this is just a radio gag. He thought I was on Paxil all this time, and I was like, no, you moron. And he goes, well, that's why I was so afraid to give you the Xanax. And I was like,
give me the Xanax.
Yeah. Yeah.
You should have went on the Zoloft, though, and then come off for the fight.
I'm on the Xanax, so I don't kill you all.
Frank, what's going on?
But that's the deal with the blindness.
Hey, Frank.
Hey, guys, this is wrong. You're crossing the line. I mean, what's next? Hemophiliac knife fighting?
Shut up, Frank.
Hemophiliac knife fighting.
Nice. Hey?
Right. Frank, shut up.
Thank Do they
Frank.
Have AIDS as well, or just...
That's blind Matt.
Oh,
I have to ask both of you. You guys are completely cool with this?
No, I'm very offended. I'm just trying to get my fighting career back. So I figure if I go in and punch Matt in the uterus and bite his ears off, because I have been preparing for the fight... By going off the Zoloft for a couple of days. Oh, so
to the I missed, Dave.
Okay. I'm sorry. I lost my big fat cowboy hat.
Blind Steve's online. Blind Steve.
Steven.
Matty, you got to do it up for this.
You pussy.
Up, baby.
Yeah, this is the guy that Dave was supposed to fight originally.
Right.
Blind
Steve. Sorry, I'm gainfully employed. No, come on.
What, couldn't make it?
No, I'm working, dude.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't handle a beating again.
Oh, whatever.
Whoa, Matty.
Just do what I told you.
I'm going to do what you told me, Coach.
Oh.
Let's get the games going. You're wasting time.
Dave, I'm going to go to a break before they start the fight. I'm going to give it.
Bye.
Steve, Like the Pink Floyd song, Wish You Were Here.
Mike.
Yeah, yeah.
Turn the radio down.
Turn the radio down.
What? Hey, Mike, turn the radio down.
Radio's off.
What's up? We got Blind Matt and Blind Dave in the studio.
Mike. Hey, what's up, guys?
What's up? You're live. Let's go.
Dude, I'm telling you what. This is the funniest stuff I've ever heard. I'm holding it down here in Columbus. I'm driving my truck around. I've never laughed out loud to anything on the radio in my life before. You guys are rocking. I love
it. Look at that, Columbus.
Hey, Columbus, Mike, I'll be in Columbus this weekend if you want to come down to say hello.
Where are you going to be?
I play.
Wait, where are you going to be in Columbus?
We're going to be at some hotel.
He doesn't know. He doesn't have to know.
Why are you going to be in Columbus, man?
Steve and I play on a team called the Long Island Bombers, which is a blind game of baseball for folks who are blind. Well, yeah, blind game baseball.
Baseball.
It's a modified game of baseball that we play. We're coming out there to have a tournament against a lot of other blind teams.
Right.
Oh, cool.
So we'll be out there. We'll be flying out tomorrow. We'll be in Columbus Saturday and Sunday. Come on down, and I will not take my eye out for you.
All right. There you go, Mike.
Hey, take care, bud.
All right, bye. What's your record there?
You know what? We lost once this year to them bastards from Keyspan. Thanks for all the money, Keyspan, but don't beat us next year. These guys play to win, man. They peek through their blindfolds.
Oh, they're sighted teams wear blindfolds.
Yeah, out here we play basically our corporate sponsors, so we have to take these long trips to Columbus to play other blind teams. But, our only loss this year against corporate sponsors is to Keyspan. Those cats play to win, and God bless them.
That Jack Daniels, holy Jesus.
Dave, slow down. Tipped
up we got to still get you to box.
Dave's making it easy.
Slow down. What's your batting average?
This year, dude, I think I made out once out of, 10 outs. About 10 times a bat. Because our pitcher's on our team. It's not like he's trying to strike us out.
Right.
You know, it's like he throws it in the wheelhouse. He knows where
fair.
We swing.
Wait, there's a blind pitcher, too?
No, he's a sighted pitcher.
Okay, and then do you hear the ball?
Yeah, the ball beeps, but it's not about hearing the ball when you bat. It's all about timing. You don't necessarily have to hear it. You just have to time it. When the pitcher pitches, he says, ready, pitch, releases the ball. You wait about a second and let it go. The base is a foam tower that stands about 3 feet tall. And also beeps a different tone, and you run as fast as you can till you trip over the base. And if you get there before another blind guy fields the ball, it's a run. If the blind guy fields the ball first, you're out.
So he's just got to grab the ball.
That's it. Okay. If you play sighted teams, they have to stand on the outfield grass until we hit the ball. Then they field the ball and throw it home to the catcher. Catcher has to touch the plate before we get to the base.
They need to have blind people catching the balls.
That would be something.
Imagine how long a baseball game would go for.
If we catch
think about it.
Yeah. If we catch the ball on a fly, it's 3 outs. Triple play.
All right.
Wow.
But, you know, it's something. You know, we were thinking a couple years ago of challenging O&A to a game. We realized you guys may be big time for us, but if you guys ever consider it, man, we'd love to play as...
We'll just drink till we're blind, and then
we'll play as...
And then we'll lose.
That's it.
Mark, I got a 135 average in bowling.
Yeah?
Yeah. I just started a month ago, man.
Really?
You know what? I think I could do that. And they said...
You just
feel where the gutters are. You walk up to the line, you feel where the gutters are with your feet, and you get in the middle and heave the ball, you know?
And you got a 135 average, and there's
I got strikes in one game.
And there's
no... in my lane.
And
but,
the pins aren't... Exactly. The pins aren't beeping or anything?
They asked you, Massachusetts, there's a lot of blind people. It's like the blind state, Massachusetts. Yeah. They're like, would you like a lane with bumpers?
Bumper lane.
What the hell are bumpers? And they're like, so when your blind ass throws the ball down the thing, it won't bother anyone else and go into their lane? I'm like,
nah, I think I'll just take the regular.
But in all seriousness, for bowlers who are blind, there's a blind bowling league here in the city. What they have is a rail, and they set this rail up in the middle of the lane, and you can
run
down the rail.
But you gotta do it for real.
It's ridiculous. I don't like the lane either.
Run down the rail?
My bowling technique is to squat, put the ball between my legs, and push it like a sissy. That's it.
All right.
That's someone letting you push the gas pedal on their car and say you're driving, you know? It ain't real, man, you know?
Frank from
drive a dirt bike, man. My friend's 250 enduro. I feel with my left foot and my right foot. I get in the middle of his dirt road. I lay it out through first, pop second, and hit third, and then come up to an abrupt stop and feel the damn, that tree would have hurt.
You know what? You know what I think? I hope that the listeners...
extreme.
I hope I think...
you
got
to live, man.
I think the listeners should get from this that, you know, while we're sitting here spoofing on our blindness a little bit and I'm popping my eye out for the show, which is something I haven't done since I'm like 16.
I know, I'm sorry.
Well, that's
about
the
mindset of this show.
Yeah, that's where we're at mentally, man.
You know what, guys? The real message is that blind folks, we do everything and anything, including popping our eyes out for a little fun.
No, let me tell you one thing.
You know what?
I'm sure not getting on a bike and blindfolding myself and popping third gear. You know,
well, that's great, though, man. My friend's father never knew I was riding the bike up at his house in the country, you know, like in upstate Connecticut, the country. And, there's a little open doorway, and I hit third gear and accidentally popped a wheelie, almost had a heart attack, and, like, went up for, like, 2 seconds, and instead of, like, letting off the throttle, I laid down on the bike, and my friend's father's like, geez, if I didn't know any better, I'd swear that was, like, Pace driving by riding a wheelie, and he was like, that was Pace.
He's riding by doing a wheelie.
Great. Harley's, his friend's like, you know, how do you do that? I'm like, well, you never lose it, dude. And I'm like, nah, I scared the crap out of myself. I don't know what the hell I'm doing, and you know.
Frank from New York quickly living, wants to know. He says that Matt plays for a blind baseball team. He wants to know if it's the New York Mets.
Hold on.
What?
Frank, we beat them. They're terrible.
In my travels...
Let's go.
In my travels of Boston,
yeah.
I could tell you one thing. Never, even if you're blind and you have a cane and people feel sorry for you, never be in a sports bar and say the Red Sox suck.
No, but I'll tell you...
Because they will beat the crap out of you and lynch you.
I'll tell you the funniest thing...
Go Sox!
Hey, Mark,
cancel your appointment.
Psycho Mark wants to get paid now for that.
I'll tell you what the funniest thing for a blind guy to do in a bar is, and that's to say, hey, I'm blind. Give me the darts. Everyone does.
Got some house darts.
Hey, Mark, what's going on?
Hey, how about next week on O&A, pregnant women kickboxing?
Pregnant woman kickboxing.
Write that down, Ant.
That's nice.
Thank you.
All right. Well, I feel good about this now.
You're feeling better about it,
the guys?
All right.
Dave, should we get a little hate going?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Shouldn't we hate each other or something?
Oh, no. Don't start bad-mouthing each other.
I'm kidding.
It's like, as the bottle turns, so does Dave's frustrated anger towards Matt.
You should let Matt feel the JD bottle to feel how much Dave just drank.
Outside, he says blind guys know the shape of every liquor bottle out there.
That's it, baby.
I've been on the wagon for like a month and a half, and 2 days ago, I thought I was coming here, and I bought 10 shooters of Jack Daniels, and I put them in my little fridge. I have a refrigerator in my room, because that's what a beer drinker I was. And,
if you need it.
Now we switch to Jack.
And it was like, okay, I'll wait till tomorrow or the next day when I go on the show. That's when I'm gonna go off the wagon.
But you're getting all itchy because you knew they were there.
And I heard this little...
Hey! Come on, we're in here! Come on, you know you want it. You know you want it.
And then I heard little clamoring around. You know, like, I went to the blind school. I came home. My parents had kittens. It was like having the gremlins in your house. You know, it was like... I hear this little creaking around and things knocking over. I'm like, what the hell is that? You know?
Like gremlins.
Yeah, and that's why I called him. I was like, I came back. I was like, oh, you got gremlins in the house. What the hell is this?
Classic.
But the little booze bottle, so 2 days ago, so if we had the fight yesterday, I would have been beaten miserably.
You should have fought
and
yesterday.
Right now I'm borderlining on being so drunk that... It's going to be really rough for me.
All right. Well.
So I'm going to lay off the Jack Daniels for a while.
Well, we're going to take a break, Ant, and we're going to do blind boxing.
Yes, when we come back, we will do blind boxing.
We won't stall, none of that crap.
Are those the bells?
I've been waiting, man, since 1 o'clock.
Blind Matt and Blind Dave will finally get it on in our ring.
All right.
We're going to do
going to be a blind your face match.
We want to do 3 rounds, 2 minutes.
Yeah, discussed that.
Three 2-minute rounds with maybe, you know, a couple of minute break in between rounds.
How about 4 rounds?
Holy mackerel. We can do that.
How's the falls go? How's that go?
Well, we don't know if either one of you are going to fall down.
Dave, I think they, from just my suspicion, Dave, they don't think we're going to hit each other. Let's make a bloody mess out of each other for these guys.
No, I think we have a...
I'm going to hit you, just I'm going to feel bad about it.
Yeah, exactly. Me too.
Three fall down rule?
Yeah.
So if you fall down three times in one round, the fight's over.
If you fall down just from drunkenness, then it don't count.
No, it'll be deemed a slip.
Do we get coaches like, could like one of you guys
I want
be my
Opie
coach
in my
and
corner.
One be Dave's coach?
Oh, that's what's going to happen. Left. We'll be in the each corner.
Yeah. And I'll do the opposite of whatever you
tell. No, but you know
me.
What? Yeah. Wait. I want quiet when we're boxing, other than the announcer who's calling the blows or this and that, because the more someone's yelling out right, left, the more that's giving it away to the other guy. I want to be sneaky.
All right, so we'll put bells on you guys. We'll be quiet.
No bells.
No bells?
Oh, Dave, you have to have
bells.
Man?
You don't want bells? How are you going to find the other guy?
You'll see.
And we won't.
Yeah. It's all a big scam, Opie. I've been working on this for 2 years.
All right.
I'm really 20/20 vision.
All right, let's...
Dr. Filatoff, diamond vision.
Let's.
The blind guy is doing diamond
Jesus
vision.
Jesus Christ now.
Or Papa Pio.
Dr. Filatoff is not Jesus Christ.
Wow.
All right, when we get back, it's these guys going at it. Tell your friends.
Padre Filatoff.
It's the BBA on ONA.
Call your friends right now. It's blind box. Boxing on the Opie and Anthony
show. It's blind boxing.
And
call
don't
your
tell
friends.
My family.
Minutes away, Anthony.
All right.
And I just got to tell people once again really fast, the picture of blind Matt when he popped his eye out, his fake eye is on WNEW.
Check that out.
And they haven't asked for a picture of my helmet yet, but we're working on that.
Blind Matt overshadowing blind Dave.
No, you got a good radio voice. No one said that about
you. You're
me.
Ripping me off. No.
Let's
Who would have thought there was all those guys named Blind Dave, though? What was up with that yesterday? I'm listening to the radio on here, and we got Blind Dave online, and I'm like, that's
I'm
not
Blind
me.
Dave. What is that?
Don't name your kid Dave.
All right, we got to find a place for the dog.
I can leave him in here or in Steve's office.
Yeah, I'm not getting bit.
Put him in Steve's office so he can't even see through the glass.
Are we still on the air? Or?
Yeah, we promise when we get back, the boxing will start up, okay?
All right.
It's the ONA show.
Wow.
K-Rock played Linkin Park at 2:58 today.
Yeah, a lot of people laughing out there.
Put the pieces of the puzzle together. You'll get it. 877-692-1027. It's the Opie and Anthony show.
Well, we have blind boxing.
Ben, you got to tell Ant what you just told me.
Listen to this. This is kind of funny. It really is.
I had an observation. I went to the bathroom to go to the bathroom, and the whole floor is soaking wet in our bathroom, just everywhere.
Did Dave just get out beforehand?
Yeah, he was right before me.
I was wondering if they were going to ask,
you need a beeper on the toilet.
That's just funny. They're getting their stuff on. We can move outside if you want it.
Yeah, we should do that. I think they're getting their equipment on right now.
Yeah.
Putting the headgear on and the gloves. And I don't know what the hell's going to happen here. We realized we didn't have ropes for the ring.
Right.
Because, we don't have a ring. We got outside. And we're going to put a couple of interns there so they could push them back into the fighting area.
Pretty much tell them that they're stepping out of the ring.
All right. Oh, my God. All right, let's go outside.
All right.
You go first.
All right.
Jesus. I don't know how this is going to play out because they don't want the bells on. They can't see. I just picture flailing wildly until someone connects. I don't really see it really turning into a boxing match.
Anthony?
You all right there?
Yeah, okay.
Let me get outside.
It's crazy out here. Wait, Dave. Dave, come over here. Dave, over here. You got to do that for the radio. He's imitating Kevin Meaney, Anthony. Hold on. Let me get a mic in front of you. I'm all tangled up here.
Yeah, that chair has to
What's
be
What's the matter? I can't see my... I don't know where my cigarette is. That's not right. What's the matter with you pulling your eyes out on national internet? You're like a crazy person.
popping your eye out.
You're not right. Look at you pulling your blindfold down.
Yeah, wait a minute. You got to put your blindfold back on. See, blind Dave can only see little things of light.
Little shapes.
But he sees a little bit.
And he wants to be fair to blind Matt, who's completely blind.
Matt's completely... He's bring the dog in blind.
I got to take this off. I
got to
fix this.
All right, hold on. Stinky.
What's the matter with you? You screwed it all.
Okay.
You're not right. What's the matter? You don't see your other blind friends hammered. Going on radio stations, boxing, making a fool of yourself. You're like a crazy person, aren't you? You're just
so
crazy.
Hammered.
I know. Steve from FoundryMusic.com. Are you taking all this in?
This
is some of the best video I have ever taped in 2.5 years.
Retard.
This is priceless.
What does he say now?
Because I heard the hammered statement. Blind people can hear. We're not retards.
That's right. We're not retarded.
Hey, I need a piece of paper because I'm one of the judges. Ben's one of the judges. Where's Ben? Ben
Where's
can come out here.
Drink?
Let's run through the rules.
Yeah.
We're going to do 3 2-minute rounds.
Correct.
And there's a 3-knockdown rule. If someone gets knocked down 3 times in 1 round, the fight's over. A slip will be deemed a slip, not a knockdown. There might be a couple of those. We'll judge this on the 10-point must system. The winner of each round getting 10 points. The loser, you could give them 7, 8, or 9 points. And I don't know if it's going to go that way. I think it's just going to be flailing until someone gets hit and knocked out. I can't see this working any other way.
And they want to do 4 rounds in.
What, you guys want to do 4 rounds?
How many rounds do you want to do, guys?
It's going to take a little endurance as he's puffing on his butt.
Not 3. 2, 4.
Wait a minute. What's the matter with you? I don't have a cigarette in my mouth.
Wait a minute. You're going to be boxing in a second. Don't be.
You can't have a cigarette in your mouth as you box.
Nicotine.
When you're boxing.
Oh, I'm okay.
The Jack Daniels, the Buds. He's ready to rock. I like it.
You're whacked out, aren't you?
All right. Hey, Stinky, let's talk to Matt. Matt, you ready to go?
I'm ready, baby.
You look good.
I'm ready to rock.
You look really good.
I got my foam face working.
I see that. Yeah, we got the headgear on them, real boxing gloves.
Now, Matt, are you going to close your eyes during this? Because you don't need them, but if he hits you hard, I don't want one of those eyes flying out.
Well, if it flies out, pick it up for me.
He has 2 prosthetic eyes, so he completely can't see.
Go to WNEW.com if you think we're lying. There's a picture of him with his eye popped out.
I've been smacked about the head plenty of times, and the eyes stayed in.
Oh, really? Okay. So, yeah, there's no threat of those things flying out of your head.
Hey, guys, I got a good idea. Why don't we get the mic cords out of the ring so the guys don't trip?
White man with small penises. These are too small.
He's hammered, man.
That's a big boxing glove.
Hammered. What are
you gotta be hammered. I saw so much Jack Daniels being swigged.
I've got a high tolerance. What's the matter with you? I'm an alcoholic. I can drink bottles of Jack Daniels.
You know, Dave,
he could smoke with boxing gloves, too. That's amazing.
Dave, you need to smoke as you do this, just to add.
No, what are you crazy?
It's too good, man.
Why wouldn't I?
All right.
I've got to be smoking.
Smoke a cigarette, and then when he gets punched in the face and it gets broken, he'll really get pissed.
Oh.
All right, are we ready to do this?
All right, let's guide the combatants into the ring.
I strap my gloves. There are no straps. What do you mean there's no... They're supposed to be...
No, there's no
trap.
They have bells on one hand.
I can't even make a fist with these.
So when they swing that right hand, you're going to hear the tinkling of the bells.
Okay.
No, there's no straps. You just hold tight with a fist.
Yeah. They're walking Matt around the ring, so he gets a kind of a feel for what it's all about. The ring's about... we should be pretty accurate, actually, for these guys. What would you say, Ant? 10 by 10?
10 by 10 is a good guess.
You're the timekeeper.
Dave's doing a little practice punching. Move your hand, Stink.
Shadow box.
He punches Stinky in the stomach. Oh, he's got a good sense of where someone is, even if he's...
No.
Even though he can't see. He could hear very well. And
Walk Dave around the ring so he gets a feel for the size of the ring and stuff. Dave,
right.
It's 10 by 10.
Maybe I shouldn't have a cigarette.
Yeah, maybe you should put that down.
Take the cigarette out of his mouth.
Now let's guide him around the ring.
I just like
to say that I have corn off the zone off in preparation for the fight.
Pete the engineer is horrified. I don't think he wants this to go down.
We're getting more and more spectators down here.
Well, what I'd say is I'm used to smacking my women about the head and face.
Matt doing Sean Connery.
I'll smack that bitch silly.
All right, they are each at a corner right now. And I don't even know how this is going to work.
I don't know.
I think there's a better chance of someone, again, the crowd getting punched.
Where am I heading towards, though?
You're just...
Yeah, but you're not telling me where I'm going in the ring. You're going right, go straight.
That's just the perimeter of the ring. Put him in the corner, face him in the right direction, right the and chin, let's get down to a brass tacks here.
Let me see. Okay.
All right, you got, three. They're feeling each other out here.
All right, hold on.
Seeing how tall each other is, it kind of.
Okay.
All right. Okay. All right, let's get to the corners.
Yeah, Dave.
F you with a gay stick.
Dave, get to your corner.
I'll punch you.
This is so, you know what? This is so wrong.
It is
one
completely
Dave is
wrong.
Completely hammered. We had to take the cigarette out of his mouth.
I'm not completely hammered.
All right, Dave, get into your corner. Stinky's got the field mic, so hopefully we'll be able to hear some of this.
All right, if someone could grab the bell from in front of my little workstation over there.
Anthony, when you ring the bell, you tend to go ding, 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 ding. Do we start fighting after the last?
The second you hear a ding, you just go.
Okay.
That's what it's all about.
Hey, we need someone on this side of the ring so you can tell them that they're out of the ring.
Hey, Matt.
Ari, get over here.
Us start, if you wouldn't mind, tagging gloves.
Yeah, shaking
hands. No shaking hands, but tag gloves so we both know where each other are.
Yeah, all right. Move to center ring.
Have the bell ring.
Move to center ring.
Are you okay with that?
All right, move Matt forward to Dave. Are you guys going to back up into your corner after you touch gloves?
Yeah, I don't know where you are.
I'm right here.
All right. There they are.
All right.
Oh, my God. I don't.
So, wait. No, Dave is saying he wants us to touch gloves and then...
No, right when the bell rings, you're going to start punching?
No, back up.
Back up.
You got to find each other.
The ick to them is us missing.
No, it's not.
No. I got this tag.
No. We just...
Oh, my God.
We just want you backed up a little.
Yeah, back up to the corner. Seriously.
Back up to the corner.
Wait. I want to know where he's at.
All right. Yeah, 2 minute rounds.
2 minute rounds.
We might have to take a break soon. We got to get at least one round in before we take a break.
We'll get a round in.
All right, they're backing back up to the corners.
Yeah, where's the mouthpiece?
Oh, there's no mouthpiece.
What happened to the mouthpieces?
Oh, you got them?
We got mouthpieces, right?
Me too.
Oh, we got some? Okay, yeah, they got mouthpieces.
We got mouthpieces.
I don't know why they didn't have them.
That wasn't in Gay Marco's mouth first, was it?
No, these are being taken out of the package right now.
All
right,
everyone be quiet so I can talk to these guys really fast. You're about... Dave, you're about 10 feet away from Matt in the opposite corner, and Matt, of course, 10 feet from Dave. Mm-hmm.
All right, the mouthpieces going in. There they go. Oh, my God.
All right.
He's burping.
Andy, get him faced the right way.
Yeah, right. There you go.
All right,
and now... you don't know if you want the mouthpiece?
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, you might as well use it. See how it works.
All right.
Yeah, you don't want to clap your teeth together.
Okay, you guys ready?
Rick, get out of the ring.
It's going to be 4 rounds.
All right, ready for blind boxing. When you guys hear the bell, we'll start. I can't believe this. Here we go. They're facing each other in the corner. And let's get ready to blind rumble! There they go. Oh, my God, they're right in front of each other, and they don't know it. They have no clue where each other is. Someone's going to get...
Okay, here they go. Wait, hold on.
Matt knocked down Dave.
Dave went down hard.
I'm not sure if it was a push.
All right, hold on.
Back to neutral corners.
Dave, how are you feeling?
That hurt. Oh, he played like he ain't going to hurt. All right, now I'm ready to go.
38 seconds.
Oh, my God.
Now I'm angry.
38 seconds of the first
38
round.
38 seconds in, we have a knockdown. All right, so Matt, knockdown. That's one knockdown for Dave. It's a 3-knockdown rule. All right, are we ready? Let's resume the round.
Okay, here we go.
All right.
A little over a minute left in the round.
Here they go. They're looking at each other.
Oh! Matt connected with... Dave connected with
Dave
the right.
Dave is now swinging. Oh, wow. All right, they got him.
All right, they're swinging like crazy.
Kinda
this has gotten really real.
They're in a clinch now.
Fight.
All right, they're out of the ring.
All right, they're out of the ring. They're out of the ring.
Break.
Wait, they're fighting after the bell. Hold on. Okay, hold on.
Oh, my God. These two are out for blood.
All right, hold on.
Hold on.
Rick is down.
Rick got punched in the face.
Okay, a lot of people got punched in the face.
Rick got punched in the face trying to break him up.
Hold on. Talk to Dave.
What's he talking about?
Talk to Dave. Dave, what's going on? Dave.
I just got body blowed. My ribs are killing me, man.
Wait a minute. Rick got knocked down.
What happened?
See,
happened? He wants to know what happened.
You guys got to understand, when someone yells break, you got to stop punching and step away.
He was still hitting me. I
guess we didn't spell that out. When we yell break, it means you guys are so far out of the ring.
Yeah, well, I heard break, and he was still hitting me in the ribs, man.
All right. Well, when we say break, you guys got to stop punching immediately and just break. Rick, give Rick the mic. Rick, what happened?
As I'm trying to angle for a great camera shot,
yeah,
I get an errant elbow from Blind Dave as he's winding up backwards to try and hit Matt.
It got you in the mouth?
He got me right in the jaw.
You almost knocked Rick
and
out.
My head hurts now.
All right. Stinky, let's talk to Matt.
I'm sorry.
Matt, how are you feeling so far?
Good.
Okay.
Matt's feeling good.
Yeah, Car. Matt. All right, listen, how many seconds left in the first round?
Yeah.
We're up to a minute 12.
Minute 12 in the first round. Yeah.
All right, a minute 12. We got
you guys,
47 seconds.
After what we have seen, we've got to do only three rounds. Yeah. Three two-minute rounds is plenty.
All right, we have a few more seconds. Remember, guys, when we yell break, you got to break.
Yeah.
Two-minute rounds, you know, three-minute, what are they, two-minute rounds?
Yeah, we're just about done with the first round. We got 48 seconds, I think, left in the
and,
first round.
And we're ready.
Me on top of the head, I think I was reborn.
Okay.
We're ready to, okay, Dave's fixing his equipment. And we're ready to resume. They're fixing their equipment. It gets what happened to your mouthpiece?
Yeah, all right, Dave.
Oh, he put it in his pocket.
You put it in your pocket, I think, Dave. They have bells on their right glove, by the way.
Holy Jesus, Palomino. The best part is when they're standing right in front of each other, but no one's punching yet. And it's like, oh, my God, he's right in front of him.
What do you mean no one's punching? He punched my ribs in.
No, I mean, when you guys square off, you were standing at one point right in front of each other, but you're just kind of moving around and not knowing that you're right in front of each other. If one person just would have thrown a punch, it would have been over.
I'm in shock.
It's a very clinch fight. It's reminiscent of the Ali Frazier fights. A lot of clinching.
All right. Here we go. The last 48 seconds of the first round, hopefully.
All right, are we ready? We're in position. Guys in the corner, you're facing the right direction. And let's go. There they go. They're back in. Oh, right. Running in.
Oh! All right, hold on.
Hold on. No, he's still going.
Okay, they're
going
to fight their way out of it.
Still going.
They're fighting.
Fighting out of it. Wow. No! Wow. Wow. The
break.
All right, they were out of the ring. Holy. Wow, what a flurry of blows that was.
All right, listen, I just got
Blind
punched.
Blind Dave working the body.
I just got punched in the nut.
Oh, God. Opie got punched in the sack. Oh, my God, Opie's down. Opie got punched in the yam bag. I knew these guys would be punching everybody. They can't see. They're just throwing punches. Opie, what do you expect? You are ringside.
I was in shock. I'm like, oh, they see I'm here. And I'm like, No, they don't.
No, they don't. They're just punching.
Is that the end of the...
No.
We still have 28 seconds left.
28 seconds left in the first round. Oh, my God. At this rate.
We can all agree that that's the end of the first round.
All right, you want to end the first round?
We're going to end the first round.
We'll take a break. We'll come back with round two. Of blind boxing.
Wait, how do they feel? We should talk to them real fast.
Yeah, how you feeling after
how's
that?
How's it going so far?
Good, a little winded.
A little winded?
Quite the flurry.
Furious pace.
Yeah.
He's got good reach, good on the inside.
Dave was working
you in the nuts.
He was working the midsection on you. I saw that happen, and Dave did a great job on the midsection. You're more of a headhunter. Matt's more of a headhunter. Dave, you did a good job on the...
You hit my ribs in like hell, man.
Because you were working his midsection pretty good. Are you hurting? You think you're going to be able?
I was hitting him.
Are you going to be able to continue for round two?
Yeah, I'm hurt, but I'm going.
All right, we'll have to continue with round two after we take a break, I guess, and these guys can rest up.
Now it's personal, he's yelling at. All right, we'll be back with Blind Boxing on the Opie and Anthony Show in just a bit. We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show outside the studio. We're in the middle of Blind Boxing.
Unbelievable.
I am stupefied today.
Yeah.
I don't know what to say.
What a display of athleticism that we have seen here so far, and it's only round one, the end of round one. We will start up round two. I forgot my bell again.
Well, they're getting their gloves back on, Anthony.
Yeah. Getting ready. I think they've assessed what they did and maybe didn't do in the first round. They're reassessing themselves, and they'll come out with a new strategy, I think.
Yeah.
Although Matt's been pretty effective.
Matt's been very effective.
I think Dave is...
Dave has figured out what he was doing wrong, and he's ready to go.
Yeah.
One thing he did wrong was punch everyone except Matt.
So far he's hit Rick in the chin and Opie in the yam bag.
In the right nut.
And you went down, man. You were on the floor.
Ugh. And that's good entertainment, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great. No, we don't want to tell anyone who's winning the fight yet.
Yeah.
And
we do have the scorecards ready.
And Ben, the judges of Blind Boxing.
Now, remember, guys, when I yell break, you guys got to stop punching and break. And
everyone else just be quiet, okay?
Well, cheer on, but...
Okay, all right. Steve is videotaping this mess.
Yeah.
I hope my mom's not listening today.
Are we all set and ready for round two of Blind Boxing?
You guys ready?
Ready, guys?
All right. Okay, here we go, Ant. On your bell. And they're off.
There they go.
All right. Just
heading toward the center of the ring.
It's always quiet at first.
It's very quiet at first until they realize...
Oh, my God.
They get so close.
No, that's not...
They get so close.
Dave is punching
the air. Dave's punching right in front of him.
Don't even say where they are.
No, I'm not. Okay. I'm not. This is the
okay, they found each other. All right, hold on.
Break. They ran right out of the ring.
Okay.
Ran right out of the ring.
25 seconds. It is really funny, Anthony. What's going on here is they don't know where each other is, and one will just start taking a stab at the air, and Matt hit Dave's back, and then they know where each other is, and then it's an all-out fight from there.
The funniest thing was when they were both facing the same direction.
Yeah.
Like usually boxers are face-to-face. They were next to each other facing the same direction.
That was very interesting.
Wow.
What happened?
I don't even know if I heard that. I'm sure they'll pick it up down the hall.
Oh, what?
Yeah, you guys, very important. You got to just break when you hear break.
Yeah, but if you're still getting punched, you're going to punch back.
All right.
Well, let's just break. We need a brave ref that's going to jump in between these guys and break them up. All right. There you go. We got one. Steve C., you're videotaping all this?
Yeah.
Very good. Check it out on foundrymusic.com. All right, we all ready to resume the round?
Yes. We only went 25 seconds there.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
Try not to wrestle so much, guys. You can't take down the legs or anything. It's boxing. Blind boxing. Here we go. Ready?
And no cheating. As far as the guys on the outside of the ring, telling them where they're at. All right, here we go.
There's the bell.
There's the bell.
Oh, yeah.
Break.
Charged, break. Wow,
Dave.
Hard to break these guys
chill,
up.
Dave, chill.
Hold on, Dave.
All right, hold on.
Oh, my okay. God. Now it is getting personal.
All right, Matt punched Dave right over a couch. All right, hold on. I have figured out what's going on here.
Yeah.
When you yell break.
Ring his bell again on his glove, and I'm going to ring your bell, buddy.
Yeah, what are you doing, Rick? You were ringing the guy's bell.
Hold on, let that guy talk. That's Dave's friend. What happened?
He was ringing Dave's bell on his wrist so the other dude could find out where he was.
Oh, Rick, you're lying. I saw the same thing.
I'll ring your bell.
I saw the same thing.
Right now with you, buddy. I'll put the gloves on
Rick, I'm agreeing with the guy. I saw it. They could dump that. Boy, this is getting nasty.
This is getting really ugly.
This is getting nasty.
9 seconds. 9 seconds.
That was 9 seconds?
I felt someone grab my wrist, and I thought it was a guy.
Yeah. Rick, could you stay out of it, please?
That's you ringing my bell, Rick. Come on. Come on. Funny's funny. You got me, but come on.
Oh,
I bet you Steve has it on tape. That's a funny
thing. Oh, part. Absolutely he does.
Let's
put that on the web.
Videotape.
Hold on. Let's go. Let's see.
Hold on. No, now we're going to see what Rick was doing.
We're going to make sure.
We're going to rewind the tape.
Because Dave's friend is really pissed off.
And he's got every right to be. What the hell are you ringing his bell for?
What the hell is that?
I saw. Rick.
All right, we're rewinding the tape, Anthony.
We have to now take a look at the tape and see what Rick was doing. Right at the beginning of the round. And he was alerting Matt to where Dave was.
All right, here they're setting up for the round.
No, it was right before.
It was right before that.
Yeah, right before
it started. Right.
Right
before Matt knocked Dave over the couch.
All right, let's get a good look here.
Exactly.
All right, here are the combatants.
Come on.
You can't see it.
You can't see it.
You can't see it because I was on
Matt.
All right, you can't see it. Steve was on Matt.
I saw it. Oh. Look at this. It's like a real fight.
All right, everyone calm down.
He's my friend. He's looking out for me. Sorry.
He can
sorry.
Say that here.
No, 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 no. He's my friend.
He's not protected. You can beat him up. I don't care. I'll laugh. I'll watch.
He's the analyst guy in this building. Everybody hates that dickhead.
Oh, my God.
Keep everyone. He's like the dickhead of the office.
Oh, my God.
He'd be the guy you'd want in the backyard to pound.
Wow.
Okay.
Hey, all right, calm down, everyone.
Let's hey, wait, you two want to put the gloves on?
See, you got to use the free ride.
You two want to put the gloves on?
Yeah. All right, no, 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 let's finish up the round.
No bad blood here, man. This is supposed to be a blind.
All right, this is, okay, let's get Matt and Dave back in the corner.
Like
let's
a not, bunch of gangsters.
Let's not shake any bells.
I'm
going to
ring his bell.
He'll watch it. All right, calm down. Calm down. Let's just leave it alone. Let's leave it alone.
Rick, no more touching anybody's bells.
He's using free
he did touch his bell.
He did. I saw it.
Well, you got Anthony's in there egging him on, agreeing with him, okay? I'm trying to keep the peace here in some kind of way, man.
It might be out of your hands, Dave, at this point. I mean,
all right,
no,
look.
I grew up with his dude. I don't want to see
this guy's, of course, going to protect you.
Yeah, he, you know.
And he should.
Right. He's just looking out for
that's
me.
Fine. Are you guys...
What Rick did was wrong, but I'm not going to get no big thing about it.
Are you guys going to...
Not no big thing about
Are you guys ready to continue or able or willing?
I'm able and ready.
All right, let's get back to...
All right, let's get the headgear
back. Let's get back to this.
You know what? Let's get rid of these bells.
Yeah, take the bells off.
Take the goddamn bells off.
This will be the last section of round two.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want the bells off.
All right, the bells are off.
All right.
Wow. Yeah. Controversy on the side of the ring.
Yeah, you got a cheating screwball on the end.
Okay.
All right, look.
Rick,
calm down.
Rick, the guy's defending his friend.
Yeah, Rick.
We saw you shake his bell. Just say, okay, I did it, and shut up. I won't do it again.
Yeah.
Dude, I did not shake his
You're
bell.
You're dead.
Oh, my God, you so did.
No, dude.
Yes, it is. Calm. He said he saw
Rick, calm
it.
Down. He's
Each of you,
his friend.
Back away, and Rick...
That.
Who the hell?
But my friend's getting it. My friend's getting hot. Well, they're saying it is. I don't.
Oh my
know.
God! Someone did blast one out.
Who the
this
hell
is disgusting.
Farted. Let's all be friends.
All right, Rick, just be quiet.
Be
everyone,
okay?
Just be quiet.
Enough. Let's get the. No, everybody. That whole thing is done with. It's over. Rick was being a tool.
You're throwing bombs. You got a second wit.
All right, this is gonna be the last.
All right.
Section of round two.
Who knew? Who knew it would get this heated?
All right, we're getting the headgear back on.
Getting the headgear on. I mean, these guys just want to box, man.
Matt, you all right over there? We haven't talked to Matt in a while.
Just fine.
Just fine?
Doing good?
I just don't want any controversy. No.
Let's do this. Let's break clean when you guys get out of the ring. And let's finish this.
Kevin's a good guy. He's been really cool the whole time. He's been feeding me Jack Daniels. So he's a good guy. He's only standing up for Dave, and I understand that.
I agree.
So if there's any misunderstanding,
misunderstanding between Rick and between Rick and Kevin. We'll set you guys up later. You can kiss and make up.
All right, the glove's going back on Dave right now. Back into the corner. Guys are getting into position, and we'll resume round two. Holy smoke. These guys, what it is they rush each other when they finally realize where they are, and it turns into just a pushing match. We don't have much room here. So, guys, you're going to have to do the stick-and-move thing. Try to keep the clinching to a minimum. All right? Are we ready? Each corner ready?
And there's the bell.
There they go. All right, more punching. Here we go. It's okay. Oh. Brick, 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 brick.
Wow.
Out of the ring again.
Dave
wow.
lost his headgear, Dave's but headgear came on really off. Strong there. Dave comes charging
out of the corner. Charging.
Found Matt, popped him a few times, and Matt retaliated.
Yeah,
and knocked.
I didn't go down until after a break.
It's okay.
Yeah, he's using the wrestling moves.
And your headgear was knocked off. That is the end of round two, Anthony.
Yeah, that will be the end of round two. We will have... We will have the third and final round.
Oh, my God. Wait, let's see if Matt's okay. Matt, are you all right?
Oh, beautiful.
Wait, Stink, get Matt the mic. You got the mic now, Matt. You all right?
I'm beautiful. A little hot. Took the headgear off, the gloves off.
Okay.
Ready to rock.
All right.
And Dave, let me tell you guys in the audience, y'all can't see this. Dave is coming on like thunder.
Yeah,
Dave,
yeah, he comes running out of the...
He's got his balls.
It's like
he's
the
got
Tyson.
The Jack Daniels buzz working. He's got them beer muscles flowing, and he's looking to behead me.
All right, and...
Spit up my ass and tell me it's raining out there, tough guy.
Very good. Dave, nice finish to the second round there. We're going to take a break, and we're going to finish blind boxing with Blind Matt and Blind David
yeah.
in just a few minutes. Stay there. This is the Opie and Anthony Show. And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show.
West Coast Dave checking in again. Down goes Opie. Down goes Opie. Down goes Opie. Beaten by a blind guy with a punch to the nuts.
Hey, that was a great shot, Dave, man. I won't forget that anytime soon.
I apologize.
No, don't apologize. Yeah, take the cigarette out of your mouth. We're ready for round three.
Ready for round three.
If you're just tuning in, this is blind boxing, Anthony.
Yes, blind boxing. We're in round three.
Definitely taking longer than the one-legged boxing.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Is it more competitive?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, it's much more evenly matched, I'll tell you that much. Woody yesterday in one-legged boxing. The one-legged boxing, Woody was overpowering his opponent yesterday. Today, a lot more evenly matched. Both... being blind,
all right, we're trying
kind of
to
hard
get,
to see each other.
We're trying to get them to their corners, Anthony.
Here we go. They're back in the corners. Remember, guys, when you hear break, all the people standing ringside, try to keep them away from falling on things.
Yeah, because Dave went flying over that couch before, man.
Yeah.
I don't mean to laugh. That was just, I'm like I said, I'm stupefied.
Are we ready for round three? Guys, are we ready?
Ready.
Okay, here we go. Blind boxing.
Matt to my left, Dave to my right.
The round has begun. Don't say anything.
Yeah, don't describe what they're doing. Okay. Hard to do that. They're radio.
They're feeling where the other guy is. Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah. Right. Okay.
There's a
lot more body blows happening.
Lots of body blows. Oh, someone got hit in the nuts. Oh, there's some serious
keep
body blows going on. Dave and
Dave,
Matt.
It's down.
And down. Okay, break.
All right,
break.
Oh, my
break.
God.
Okay,
Dave.
Okay. You guys are separated.
Dave, you can't. You can't kick.
He's blind.
Is Dave all right? Hold on. Dave might be out of the fight. Dave? Hold on.
Did you get a nut shot in there?
Dave took one to the nut. Let's just put it down.
Oh, damn, a low blow. I'm sure he didn't mean it.
Matt is saying he didn't mean it, Dave. Is that
yeah,
cool?
Yeah, kind of hard to see where you're punching.
All right.
Oh, boy.
Know what's going on here?
Yeah.
When we say break, there's guys grabbing each fighter, and the fighters don't know that it's not the other boxer, so they just
right.
keep swinging.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
I heard break, and I thought we had an agreement not to keep hitting each other. And I heard break. You were punching me in the ribs. You hit me in the same spot in the ribs every time, man.
Matt, are you hitting after the bell?
No, watch.
See, I think Opie's right. I think they're getting confused. When we yell break, everyone steps in, and you're still feeling hands on you. And I think...
You think it's the other fighter.
Cool, man.
Dave,
I know how you feel.
Hey, Dave, I don't know if you could continue.
Can you continue?
No, I can continue.
You sure? Can?
Oh, you think I'm going to quit now?
All right.
No way.
Whew. All right. We're going to have to deduct a point for the low blow.
Oh.
We're going to have to.
Oh, wow.
The only way to make sure the judges have that, we got to deduct a point. For the low blow. Well, we have to.
Shut up. You're supposed to be my friend.
Friend, man. You can't see what you're doing, dude.
Wait a minute. He's blind.
All right. I told him he punched me in the nuts. And he
you felt it. He didn't see it.
And all right. Wait, Dave. Dave, do you want us to deduct a point for getting hit in the nut?
No, that's unfair.
Go ahead. I'm losing miserably anyway, so what difference does it make?
Your friend is saying it's unfair. It's up to you, though.
Deducted.
Matt's saying deduct it.
Deduct
huh?
it.
That's the same friend who wants to box Rick.
Well, you know, we just got to go by the rules here. It was a low
Rick
blow, and
our ride home, and you got my friend threatening to box him. So,
and it is a shorter fight, so we can't go with a warning or anything. We just have to deduct the
what
point.
What does Dave's friend think?
I don't think it should be deducted.
Yeah. Okay. All right, yeah, let's...
Come on, Dave.
All right, hey, I'm overruled. I'm being unbiased, and I'm just...
All right, let's get back into the corners.
All right.
There's two more sections left to this round.
Yeah, I think we're working it when we have to yell break three times. That's when the round's over.
Yeah, yeah, because this...
It's getting crazy.
They're trash-talking now, Ant. What, Matt?
A lot of trash-talking.
Matt? Matt, you all right?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Stinky puts the mic in front of his face and doesn't. You know, he doesn't know.
The testicles are intact.
You can't say that.
All right, the combatants being led back to their corners again.
Yeah.
We have two more little segments of fighting here.
All right, you guys ready?
Corners ready?
On the bell. Here we go. And they're out.
Right.
Hey, they're filling in. Nope. Oh my God. No.
Don't move.
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Wow, Matt with the sneak attack from behind. All right, they're down. Break. All right, they both.
There we go. That was good.
Holy.
Wow.
S.
Actually, that time Dave backed into Matt. Matt then realized, because Dave first went out after Stinky. You started throwing punches at Stinky. Stinky's backing up like, oh my God, I'm going to get hit. And then you started backing up again because you realized you came too far. You backed into Matt, and Matt roundhoused you a little bit. Anthony.
I need a second. Any boxer that's been hit from behind.
Well, that's part of blind boxing, I think. Anthony.
I need a second.
All right, you got the second. And my heart is in my throat because Dave is kind of searching out Matt. Dave's gloves were literally 6 inches from my head, and I'm like, Oh, my God, if he swings now, I'm
he's
so
he's just
going
to punch you in the face.
Man, he's throwing haymakers.
He is throwing it. How do you know he's throwing haymakers?
He's hitting me.
Wait a minute. How do you know I'm throwing haymakers?
Dave, trust me. He popped both eyes out 2 hours ago, so. All right.
Yeah,
that is the truth.
Possibly see.
Okay. This is the last section of the last fight we ever do as far as blind guys go.
The last blind boxing you'll ever hear. Oh, my God.
This could be
that
it. This is radio history, Anthony.
That hurt bad.
Did it? Where did he clock you?
Now I'm pissed.
Where did he get you?
Your friend.
Where he keeps getting me. In the ribs.
In the ribs. He's working those ribs, man. Okay.
The way you were backing up.
He got me all in the side.
Wow. Dave, your friend is hilarious. He's abusing you.
It's the first time you actually see
really
a boxer.
We better ride home because after all this...
You're getting a ride home. What do you think we're going to do after the show is over? Just kick you to the curb and say thanks, guys?
Hey, look, this guy's giving me a microphone. I don't know what the hell he's handing me. I'm thinking it's my eye goggles here.
All right, there's your eye goggles.
Well, I don't know that.
All right.
A drunken blind idiot.
Oh, my God.
You got the crap pounded out of me. Give me a break, man.
You're holding your own, man.
You rarely see boxers in the defensive stance, one behind the other,
right.
Like that. And then you backed into Matt.
Dave's friend is going, man, you might as well let him. We can't even say what he said.
I defy anyone to say that you... You're ripping me off. This in radio. This has never been done.
I've never seen
BBA
this.
Now I know. Blind Boxing Alcoholics of ONA.
Now I know why they've never done this on radio before. because it is just brutal to watch.
Painful being here, man.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. This is the last section of the last round.
Here we go, guys.
Last blind fight.
Try to keep it in the ring. I know that's kind of hard, but it is the last last brawling we're going to be doing.
You guys aren't blind. Put the headgear on the right way.
Dave getting his headgear put on.
Okay.
They're all trying right. to talk with their mouthpieces in.
All right.
Here it is.
This is it, guys.
This will be the last little brawl.
No, I could wait.
That they have.
I'll have it after.
Dave putting his gloves on now, being led back to the corner.
Here, let's Matt get him back in the corner. Okay, here we go, guys. This is it. This is for the marbles. This is for the title.
I'll wait.
Mouthpiece going in.
You guys Matt? Ready?
They're everyone ready. Ready?
All right, here we go.
There it goes.
Whoa, whoa.
Wait, now they're fighting. Okay.
All right, there we go. Keep them in the ring.
We'll explain what happened in a second. And Dave's down.
Hold on. That was a slip. Dave, yeah, just get up and continue.
Maybe Dave doesn't want to continue.
No.
All right. Because that was a slip. It wasn't really a...
All right, I got to explain. Dave went flying right past Matt when they came out of the corners, and Dave started punching his friend pretty good.
Yeah, he was beating up his friend.
He knocked a beer out of his friend's hand, and his friend the whole time's going, nope, not me.
He did. He ran at him and just started beating up his friend.
He thought his friend was mad.
You were punching the hell out of me, buddy. Well, he started to.
All right, that was a slip, so we're going to...
Yeah, that was a slip, so we'll go again.
Okay, here we go.
All right, you're back in your corners. Fighters ready?
And this is it.
Don't punch me again, Dave.
Here we go. We're not going to tell you. All right, they're okay.
Whoa, wow.
They're just kind of swinging. All right, one of the interns just got knocked down by a haymaker from Dave.
You're in a dangerous position.
Okay, there they go. They found each other. They're fighting.
Don't go into Don and Mike's show.
All right, they're fighting. Hold on.
Was that a slip?
Yeah, it was a slip. That was a slip? We got to finish this, guys.
Oh, my God.
One of the interns got knocked down by a...
Off the couch.
What's scary is these guys feel somebody and they think it's the fire and just go crazy.
Another side note, you know, Don and Mike are here and they're broadcasting from the other studio. They're on the air and the fighters went flying through the door.
Oh, my God.
We should have the fight spill into their studio.
Spill into their studio.
That would be hilarious.
Oh, my God.
All right, are we ready now to finish this up?
Give me a second.
Oh, no. All right. You know, Dave, you don't have to continue.
Yeah, you don't have
to. No way am I stop.
All right. All right. This will be the last segment. Slip, fall, knockout, knockdown, tumble in, whatever.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? Win or lose, I'd rather get the crap beat out of me here than be a puss like Steve and not show up.
A little more trash talking.
Yes, that was the guy that Dave was supposed to fight.
All right, they're back in the corners.
All right, let's go.
Dave.
All right, hold on, Matt.
Hold on. Wait for the bell, Matt. Matt is the consummate professional. He's the one that's been standing in the corner waiting after every segment. Dave takes his stuff off, starts talking.
starts smoking his butt.
The gloves come up. And Matt just stands there waiting.
Stinky, what did we miss? They're all laughing. What happened?
Oh my God. That's the way they made him.
All right, here we go.
Eye of the tiger. All right, fight is ready. Here it is, the last one.
Go a little further.
This is going to be it, guys.
This is it.
And they're off.
Uh-oh. That's your friend. That's your friend. That's wrong guy. All right, hold on.
Get back in the ring.
All right, you're back in the ring now. Go.
No, that's Stinky.
That's Stinky.
Don't punch Stinky.
All right, they're trying to find each other. They're kind of wandering around the ring. No.
As
soon as they touch someone, they think it's...
That's all right. Those are the ropes.
All right. Okay. No.
That's Stinky. That's Stinky.
Okay. Hold it.
No, that's Opie. No, that's Opie.
All right. I already got one.
No, that's it.
There they go.
They found each other.
They're fighting. Okay.
All right, they're...
That is it. That's the end of blind boxing right there.
Oh, my God.
That is the end of blind boxing.
Woo! What a great last round.
That was an excellent round.
There was a lot of swinging at everybody but the fighters. Why?
Because he came in, everyone's yelling, go, 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 pushing me this way and that.
No,
because
you were punching Stinky, Opie, and Fat Guy,
I wanted the round to end, start over. Seconds over.
No.
We are done with blind boxing.
Yeah, we will now
you guys
go to the judges.
Get their gear off. You guys, let's hear from Matt and Dave. Come on.
Oh, my God.
What a day for sport. Get these guys into the studio.
Wow.
And I and Ben are going to go into the studio here and
tabulate,
figure out who won that last round there. We're not taking a break. We got to finish the show here. So
that was the funniest round yet, Opie. Did you see how long they just went between?
That is, you know what? That is so nerve-wracking because they're just wandering around the ring trying to find each other.
Swinging
at everything. Everything.
I think Rick didn't get punched that time. Stinky got punched. Fat Guy got punched. All the other guys got punched. One of the interns, you see him fly off the chair?
Yeah.
He got the house, man. Bam.
We gotta write our scores down.
I'm gonna
you can say it, they can't hear us.
Let me see. I'm gonna score that one. I gotta make it a draw.
A draw?
Yeah. I gotta go a draw on that last round. It was very even.
You know you're right about that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, that third round was a draw.
So we tabulate.
Let's tabulate here. And talk. I gotta do this.
Well, I can't see the scoring. Should be easy.
Do you want them in right now?
Not really.
No, not yet. We'll tabulate the scores, bring them in quickly, and then decide our winner.
Huh?
God, it is so scary when they're just walking around with the gloves on, their guards up, and they're just swinging at whoever they come in contact with. Like they back into somebody and then turn around and take a swing at them.
Okay. Okay.
You need a calculator rope?
No.
You all right?
Oh, wow.
You almost got punched, too, when he was coming at you. The glove's like 6 inches away from your face.
Okay, I got a total.
You got a total?
I believe so. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Let's see. Let me see the scores. Wow.
Okay, well, let's bring the guys in. There are still trash talking out there, Ant. How do they do it again? How does the ring announcer do it again?
Well, usually you
each round or
no? How they score the how the three judges scored all the rounds?
Right. What's the score?
Yeah.
Okay. Matt's in the studio. His gear is off.
Woo! I'm sweating. Dave put up a great fight, guys. That was entertaining for me. It was fun. I'd do it again anytime.
You're sweating like crazy.
I'm sweating like crazy. It was work.
All right, Dave. Dave is very winded. He's on his knees right now. Dave, you all right?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
A damn cigarette.
He's praying.
Oh, he's trying to get a cigarette. And you're figuring it out? How to do it?
Yeah, I just want to get the final thing. Right.
Okay. Yeah.
For everybody's information, we were drinking Jack Daniels between rounds.
And lots of it. We got some great, great pictures.
That's a telling shot.
Whoa. I just broke a camera. Hold on. We got great pictures.
Neither one of them in the ring. This is when they were swinging.
That's what you guys were looking for. I'm glad you got it.
We have a picture of the ring and where the boxes are supposed to be, and it's just a picture of a blank ring.
They're just both out of range.
Right, Blind Dave, very quiet now after...
You all right, Dave? How are your ribs?
A brutal beating.
You all right, though?
A brutal beating? You backed into a bunch of punches.
I kept getting hit from... I kept winding up where Blind Matt was... finding me from behind and getting the body shots in, and I got to tell you, he got me good. I'm feeling it. It hurts to breathe. I'm guessing a brutal beating was received.
Well, like what I'd like to say.
All right, we have 2 minutes left in the show.
Three rounds. Let's get to the ring announcer.
Wait, let's get everyone in here for the announcement of the
big announcement.
Let's get everyone in the studio that witnessed blind boxing.
It was a good fight, but I lost and I concede.
It was a great fight.
I bow to Blind Matt. No, he can't see me bowing, but I bow to him. He kicked my
Dave,
butt.
Dave, I'm right behind you. Don't
he
bend over.
He kicked my butt, but there was no giving up.
All right,
blind
okay.
Steve is still a big puss.
Blind boxing has ended in a decision.
Gee, let's
Judge
see
Anthony
who the winner is.
Scores it 30-27. Judge Opie scores 30-27. Judge Ben scores 30-25. And the winner and new champion of blind boxing is Blind Matt.
Woo!
Blind Matt.
I'd like to thank God. I'd like to thank God right now. I'd like to thank God for the talent he gave me. I'd like to thank God. And I would thank God again.
God.
And I'd like to thank God again.
God and God.
You guys, you guys, we have a minute left of the show.
There's a guy when he wins, he wins gracefully. There's a guy when he can't see a guy, he winds up, he comes behind him, and that's going to be that.
I'd like to say that's hitting from behind. That's what I'd like to say.
What a brawl.
Look at Dave doing Frank Caliendo doing John Madden.
John Madden.
All right, yeah, guys.
I would like to thank Opie and Anthony for having Dave and I on the show. It was a competitive match. Dave hit me in the gut a few good times on the top of the head.
Yeah.
And there's it was a guy, when he wins gracefully.
Matt, you want to...
Matt, if I was you, I would have had Dave give me a hummer.
Matt, you want to...
We'll talk about that after.
Hey, Matt, you want to say hi to anyone?
I just want to send love out to my family, Kendra, Trevor, and Tuscany. God bless y'all, and I know I did this against your wishes. Sorry to all the other blind people who we made ridicules out of today. God bless Opie and Anthony for having us. Thanks, Dave, for putting this on. Kevin, Dave's friend, for getting us both here. Thanks to, what was his name? Caro? In
right.
the car. Caro,
yeah.
What's up?
Caro from Vital Transportation.
We are.
And yo, anybody.
1-800-GO-VITAL.
That guy was cool. That guy was really cool.
As I said earlier today, guys, if anybody's interested in the Long Island Bombers, go to libombers.com. We're looking for corporate sponsorship and other blind guys to join the team. Let's do it. Columbus, we'll be in Columbus this weekend playing beeper ball, baby.
We are out of time.
Well, no, we got to let Dave say something. Dave, final thoughts.
Tyler Construction, Darien, Connecticut, and Above All Roofing, Phil Martineau says Bart the Tart May is a retard.
All right. And with that, there's really nothing else to say, so we're out of here.
Nice.
Woo!
Thank you.